can be the text file, can be your log file also. So you have a log file in your the system whenever you run your programs or something, or you will be getting some log files. Or it may be one of your email, or you want to check for the student data, or some kind of a data sent by a particular person, whatever it may be. Or it may be a data in an hospital, whatever it may be. So it looks something like this. So it will have n number of information, so many lines. So it has something around 400 lines. It can be running into some thousands of lines also. So you will be getting some kind of this raw data. Okay, this is your raw data. It can be anything. You can name it as a text file, or usually it will be a text file. So TX, or sometimes it will be RTF also, rich text file also, whatever it is. So now, if I want to write a code for this actually, if I want to write a code, so what we try to do actually, suppose we take a new window. The first and the foremost thing what we try to do is actually, we try to import the regular expression. Import space RE. Okay, import space RE means I'm trying to import the regular expressions. That is your, we call it as maybe a module or whatever it may be, import RE. So that should be our first thing. Now, I need to define your file. I need to open your file. So let me call it as open your file. I have to define it to some kind of a variable. Let me call it as some kind of an, what it is I need to check. Let me call it as CHE, okay, is equal to, I need to open the file, okay, open. So I'm going to open the file. So it is within the string, that is mbox, okay, short.txt. Okay, this is my file. Now, see, I have this particular file. See, I have this particular file. This is what mbox text actually. Now I'm opening the file. So I need to check for something in it actually. So what I need to do, I need to search for, I have different thing actually. So now check for some kind of a, some line, for line in check, okay, colon, okay, for line in the check. Now what I need to check actually, line, line is equal, first I need to strip it actually, R strip. So what I'm going to use, line dot R strip, I'm going to break it into different. So R strip is a function. R strip, already I have discussed, R strip is a function where it's going to take and divide it into different words actually. Then in that I need to do some operation. What is it? I'm going to use the regular expressions to search it. So if R E dot S A R S A R H, what I'll be searching. So let me search for a simple one. Let me, first word is there. So let me search for from, okay. So from colon, okay. Now where I need to search actually, in the, I have to search in the line, because I'm trying to take that line. So check is the particular, that particular text file where I'm reading. So in that I'm calling it as a line. So I need to search for that particular string in the line, that is a colon, okay. Then let me print it. So let me print it. So print, RER, print the line. Okay, I'm calling it as a line. Okay, now I'm going to save it actually. So where I need to save, I'm going to save in my file. So where is Python codes? So let me call it as RE example one. So RE underscore one dot py. Okay. So this is what I have actually. Now let me go to my terminal and try to run this code. I'm going to open my terminal. Okay. In the terminal, I'm going to run the Python 3 RE underscore one dot py. Okay, so what is it actually? Mbox test. Literal syntax. Mbox box where is it actually? Payment box, it is not here. Bring it here, 1 minute. Where is my inbox? Here it is. So I have to bring it. So this, I have to bring it, as it's not there. Now it will come. Okay. It was outside the folder. Inbox. So what is the name I have given? Inbox. Inbox.txt, that's it. Okay. So here, if you go and check your file, is mbox.txt. It's not short. mbox.txt. Okay, that's the name I given. So now that's why it's giving error. Now let me run this code. Clear and run this code. Oh, it is a string. I have to close the string. So the string actually, now it is done. Okay, see this? What it has taken, so just I'll run the code. Okay, clear. Just I'm running this code, Python 3 re underscore 1 dot 5. What it has done, see, I ran this code. I checked for, if you go on the thing, I checked for the from, what are the lines which is starting with from. All the lines which are starting with the from in that particular file. Okay. If you want to go and check it manually in this file, it is difficult. Look at this. From Stephen, whatever you got it. Then from where and all, the from is there. I'm trying to get it. All the file. Look at this. This is output. I'll try to put the output to the parallel to the right hand side. Look at this particular thing. Look at this. Starting from, it has checked, I think. If you want, you can check the smaller also. See, this is a very long code. See this? From Stephen Mark at ucat.ac.z. Then from, it checked for the, it went to the next one. From, where is it? Capital from, check for Louis. Stephen Mark. Yeah, here it is. Look at this. This is the first thing what is checked. This line it has checked actually. From colon Stephen dot marker at UCAT. So it is just checking for this particular word. From colon Stephen. So I'm just checking for all the words which begins with from dot and whatever this particular thing. All the lines. This I'm able to get it using your R string. So if I use that R string, I'm able to split the old files into different lines. And from there, I'm trying to check it. This is what I'm trying to do. So I'm using the regular expression and trying to get it. Now, suppose if I try to use the thing starting from, so instead of this particular thing, what I'm going to do actually, I'll just change the code. Same thing, I'll try to open the same mbox text. So I'm trying to check in this particular actually. I will just change this syntax in the search form. What I'm going to do actually, this thing I'm going to change. This thing I'm going to change. So I'm going to use this hash. So that is actually from, so instead of f, I'm going to put two dots. That means starting with f, two dots and m. Okay, colon, then line. So now what it will check actually, now I'm going to save this code. I'll just go here, clear. Now I'll try to run the same code. See, what I did actually, here, there it was, I was trying to check for the direct word from. Here, I'm trying to check for a word beginning with F. In between I have any, it can be anything, it need not be from, it can be anything. But in between F and M, there should be two letters. So that's why I'm representing by two letters, two dots, and it ending with M. So yesterday I was trying to give some examples. So here I've taken this particular file as an example, and I'm trying to use this particular meta characters. I'm using that meta characters and trying to get the same result. So here F dot dot means it's actually I can take anything. It can be F 1 2 M, it can be F 2 4 M, otherwise F one kind of a symbol, whatever it may be. In between the two dots, it can be anything. See, here the period, we call that as the period characters in the regular expression. So it has to match that particular thing what I'm searching for. Okay, this is called as character matching. So there it was, I was trying to match the word. Okay, now I'll make a little bit of changes here. What I'm going to use actually, I'll go back to my previous thing. I'll use this from. Okay, once again from. And then I'll put the colon, and I'm going to add one thing. Dot plus at. Okay, what does it do? So whenever I'm trying to do, see, from the search string, it will search the match the lines that starts with from, followed by one or more characters. See, when I put dot plus from, followed by one or more characters, and the at sign. So this will match that particular line. Okay, now we'll save this code. So look at this, very specifically I'm trying to put dot plus. Go back and see what I put in actually. Those are called as meta characters. Plus dot plus at. I'll save this code. Okay, and I will try to run this. I will just go back, clear my terminal. Okay, I'll run this code. So it's doing the same thing. Look at this. So same expressions, so whatever I want, I can get it in different format. So here what I'm trying to do actually, so from, it can be anything, from colon dot plus at, and so they're specifically checking for email ID. From colon, it can be anything. So it is searching for all that particular line, it is giving the output. So these are the different ways of checking your line or checking your matching your case. Okay. Now, say for example, I want to extract a particular case in that. So if I want to do that, let me go and change this particular thing. So let me add this plus at as it is. Okay. And then I'm going to change it. So we're going to put slash s. Okay, to the right hand side also slash s. Then I'm going to put plus. Why I'm putting the plus? It is one or more. Okay, so here instead of searching, I have to find actually. So I'm going to use the same thing. I need to find for it actually. So I'm going to change the your function to find. So find in that. Now, say for example, I want to print that particular thing. So print the line is what I'm going to do. So I can search for this particular. Now I'm going to save this code. So look at this. And I'm going to run the code. I'll run it. So clear. Okay. I'll run the code. It'll run. So now what it has done. That's what it has done. So look at this. It is searching for, see, it's a very long code what I have taken. What it has done actually, it has, see, this regular would match that particular expression, or I need to put something over here. Let me put it as if RE, let me not check. If here, it should be greater than 0 or something like that. So if RE is equal to, let me put it as some X is equal to, yeah, some X is equal to this particular thing. If your, let me call it as some Zen, okay, Zen of X is something like greater than 0, then let me print this X. Let me check for only a particular case. Let me check for a particular case. Okay, now I'm going to run this code. Because that gives a very general thing, let us be very particular. Okay. Find all, RE, find all, colon, S, plus at, S, plus, line. Okay, looking this time. So what has happened? Syntax error. Line column. Oh, yeah. There should not be any column there. Yeah. Okay. Clear. Yeah. Then it's not defined. So I have to define the then. So let me define Zen is equal to 0. Okay. So Zen is equal to Zen of X. So let me define Zen is equal to 0. This is not callable, okay. The error is being for line in N. Line is equal to line dot strip. Okay, that is fine. Check is open in box type. And line R strip. Okay, I think I have to change the. Okay, let's use inbox short code. Let me change it to okay. Let me open this file inbox short. Okay, it is very similar to that, but it's a smaller file, slightly a smaller file compared to that actually. So let me take this code and try to run. Sometimes this syntax error will come. Just run this. What's happening? Zen is not defined. Oh, I have to define len, sorry, not zen. It's len. I'm trying to find the length of it, not the zen. Okay. Yeah. Now look at it. What I'm trying to do, I'm trying to check for the all the email IDs. Just I'm checking for only the email IDs. Look at this. T fun C. I'm trying to check for the characters to the left as well as to the right. So slash S means that is the characters. Plus Q means it can be anything. It can be one or more. To the right hand side of at actually, it can be one or more. Okay. Then, so if that particular, the length of that particular character is greater than 0, I'm trying to print it. So this is an optional thing I'm trying to put. Y means if it is 0, that means if there are no characters, it should not print. That's the reason why I'm trying to put this. So what does it do actually? So it tries to open a particular file. Then it's going to divide it into R step actually. So that means it's going to divide it into different lines in that particular file. So line by line, it's going to check. Then in that, I'm trying to find for the email IDs. See, this example, what I'm trying to give actually, this may be very helpful whenever you try to collect the data of a particular, maybe you go to a particular shop and all. So usually you visit a shop and they ask you to, so please enter your email ID and phone number. Okay, email ID and phone number. So we try to give it actually. What they do actually, they try to put all these things in a particular data and try to create a data file. So that data file may be having thousands of lines. So in that, you may have to segregate only the email IDs. So in that, so you need not write a full big code actually. You just go and write, use the regular expressions. Use C. What is the simple thing? You have to open the file, check for C. You divide that particular into line by line, then check for that particular thing, what you want. You want only email ID or you want a phone number. So if you want even phone number, you can just put the numbers. So you can put the numbers. So now, say for example, if I want to check for a particular thing, something like to the left hand side, I have a set of numbers and all. Okay. Here only the letters will come. Suppose the same thing I want to check for some kind of a numbers. So it can be anything A to Z or A to capital Z, or it can be this thing. So what I will do, I'll put it in the square bracket. So it is small a to small z, then capital A to capital Z, then the number 0 to 9, and square, then close your square bracket. The same thing you can do to the right hand side also. So you can do to the right hand side, but usually to the right hand side, say for example, I can put, see here, if you want to check for only the, you want to the email ID is only with the .com. Okay. You know, if you want, you can check it actually, or you can check for a A to Z. Okay. And capital A to Z, and close the square bracket. So now what does it do? So if you check the previous thing output, I will check for the previous. See here actually what has happened. It has checked for all the, this particular thing. You can check for the email IDs. Now, when I try to do this particular code, so there is a little bit of comp. You can see here, I will check for the letters A to Z or numbers followed by zero or more with the blank characters. And what I'm going to do here actually, so instead of plus, the same thing, I will put star. Okay. There, if I try to put the plus, actually, it checked actually. Now when I'm doing this actually, when I'm particularly checking for it actually. So what will happen actually, it will check for a zero or more than one blank character. That's what it's going to do. So slash S star to the left hand side of the at, and slash S star to the right side of the at. So this particular thing, note, see, we switched from plus to star sign to indicate zero or more blank characters, to be very specific. Okay, so what are those actually? To the left hand side, I have A to the small letters AZ, capital AZ, or 0 to 9. So it can be any character. I will get the same output. If I try to run this code, I have to get the same output. Clear? If I run the code, I have to get the same output what I got. You can check it. You can create your own data file. There is an email ID or something, and you can read any file and you can. The same output, see, these are the different ways of getting the same output using your meta characters. Okay, I'm trying to check it. So whatever the thing I got it, I can get it. Say for example, is there any, see, look at this. What are the things I have actually? So .org is there. Okay, .org is there. Now to the right hand side. So let me copy this. Let me comment this. And here, what I'm going to do actually, I will go here, and in the square bracket, I'll put dot org. It will check for only the org. Okay, now save this and come back to your code and clear. Here. What I did, I'm checking only for org. So now if I look at my output, what it has taken, look at this. My output, it is just checking for the org. That is only organization. This particular thing, look at this. Org, all the things. So only orgs is getting printed. only orgs are coming. So only orgs, it's trying to get the output. Others, I'm not getting it. Even though it's there, it's giving you numbers, but I'm trying to get only the orgs in the email ID. Others, I'm trying to neglect it. Even though it's finding, but only the orgs are getting printed or displayed in your output. If I want to do that, I'm trying to do this. Or if you want to do a com, say for example, you are looking at only gmail.com. So just go and change it to com. Or you want to say, for example, ac.in. Or you are checking, say for example, you have a mix of Gmail IDs, you have a mix of Yahoo ID, you have a mix of BMS email IDs. Now you want to only search for bmsc.co to the right hand side, what you do? At s*bmsc.ac.in. So I'm going to segregate only the BMSC email ID and put it across. Okay. Now, so if, for example, I want to combine some searching operations. So combine some searching operations. So what is this combining the searching operation? So combine the searching operations if I want to do. So what should I do? Say, for example, we want to extract some regular expression. Say we want to some X followed by zero characters. So from number followed by zero characters. Then to the right hand side, I have some numbers. Okay, some numbers. Okay, so let me change this actually. What I'm going to do. So we use this expression. Okay. So use this. So X R E find all to the left hand side. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change it actually. So this I'm going to remove. So I'm going to begin with X slash S star. Okay. Colon. Okay. Then I'll check for only numbers to the right hand side. Okay, I'll check for only the numbers. So let me be 0 to some 9. 0 to 9. And I want to put a dot. So 0 to 9 means it can be anything with a dot. Then to the right hand side, I'm putting a plus sign. Okay, it can be anything after the plus sign also. So now I don't want to check for the length of it. Just I'll go to print that particular thing. So X, I'm going to print it. So here I need to use the if symbol. So if I need to, this is an if expression. I'm going to if re dot is a search operation instead of find all. I told that what are the functions we'll be using, either find all or search regularly. So here it is search operation. Search operation. So I'm going to put a colon at the end. So I want to, what I'm trying to do. So when we run this program, what we are going to get actually? So let me save this code and I'm going to run this code. Look at this. X is not the size. Actually, it is like not X. Yeah. I'm going to save it. Save. Yeah. Look at this. What exactly? Look at this, what exactly. Now, if you want to look at this actually, what it is actually, we see the data filter. See, I want to do this. See here, I want to check for the confidence and probability of that particular thing. That means I will check for that particular thing, whatever is there, which is starting with X. See, if I want, let me show that. See, here, if you look at this particular thing, I have X content. I have X D spam confidence. I have X D spam probability. What I'm trying to check here in this program by reading the regular expressions, anything which is starting with capital X, fine. It has to begin with X and it can be of anything. It can be of anything. To the right hand side, there should be a number from 0 to 9. It can be anything from 0 to 9. So now, that means you are trying to search for such numbers or such expressions in your text file. See, I am showing you maybe 100 lines or two. So sometimes this data, a text file will be of thousands of lines. So in the thousands of lines, if you want to search manually, it's very difficult. So now I'm trying to search, just I'm showing a few things. So now if you want, look at this. XCU, CMU, CU 2.3, no, it's not allowed because to the right hand side, I'm looking for a number. So you can just check it. I'm just looking for the number. So X, this time confidence, then probability. So it is starting with X and ending with that, but after colon, I have a number. So only those things I'm trying to get displayed. Okay. I'm not looking at only XC. If you look at it, actually, so here I have it. Actually. X, D-spam confidence, this one. X, D-spam probability, this one. Next. All the things. So if I try to look into each and every file, here also I have. X, D-spam result, innocent. It won't, because it's a, to the right hand side, I don't have a number. I have this particular thing. So here, I have a number. So here, I have a number. Okay, so like this, you can search for whatever I have in that particular file. You can search for email ID, you can search for a particular word, you can search for a phone number. Okay, you can search for a phone number also. So just go here. So instead of this particular thing, I can just search for example, in the text file, what I told you are collecting some data. So you are collecting the name of the person. So is email ID, is contact number, everything. So here, if you go on, so here, so two things are very important. Which function I'm trying to use? Search is one thing, find all is another thing. So regularly, these two things are very, maybe 9 out of 10 times, these two things are used. So other we have other functions which is used depending upon my requirement. So search, find all is the two functions which are regularly used in your regular expressions. Okay. Now, say for example, you want to find only the numbers. Okay, you want to search only for the numbers actually. So the same code what I'm going to do actually, I'm going to make a little bit of change and I will search for, I'll check for only the numbers. I'll ensure that only the numbers are printed. What I'm going to do, I'm going to change this if statement. Okay, so that is the same line. So what I'm going to do, if the length of X is greater than 0, okay, 0, colon, and I'm going to print the X. So here, print X. I'm trying to search for the C. So what I'm trying to do here, actually now I'll try to run the code. You see that, see the difference. All the numbers get printed here. So the left hand side, these things won't get printed. But I'm trying to underline, no? I'm trying to block that these numbers. So only your numbers get printed. So clear. Yeah, I need to define this X is equal to this. Now it will run. Now the code will run. It's not a search operation, it's a find all operation, sorry. Is a find all. It's not a search, it's a find all operation. Yeah, now it has to work. Yeah, now it has to work. Because there's a find all operation. So now, yeah. So only that number should come. Print X star. Only I need to print. This is why I need to close this one. If I want to get only that particular print out, I need to put it in this particular bracket. Yeah. If I try to do this, I'm going to get clear. Yeah. Yeah. So what I did actually, I was searching for the, I took this particular file and searched for all the things which is starting, see, this particular thing, all the things which is starting with X, with the number. Okay. In that, I am trying to check this particular number. See, I am going to check this particular numbers, only numbers, this particular thing. And that particular thing, length of that particular number, I am trying to print it. That's what I am trying to do. So now, if you look for the output, look at this. All the numbers, 0.8475, 0.00, 0.6178, 0.6961, only the numbers get printed as an output. This is one beauty of your regular expressions. Okay. Now, so if you want, you can do many things. Say, for example, I want to check for a particular number. I want to check for a, sometimes in your data, you might be having a particular PIN code. Okay. You might be having a particular PIN code of a particular or address of a particular person. So you want to search for it. So what you do, just go and find that particular thing or search for that particular thing. Use that particular thing, maybe use any of the meta character. What you want to search? You want to search for the number 0 to 9, you put it and you get it printed. So I'm trying to give you a very simple examples. Simple examples in a text file, what and all you can do. So what I'm going to do is actually, I will try to share with you one a big document. It's a very, very big document.